Well, they're still kind of getting to know each other. So it's an unspecified period of time, somewhere in the neighborhood of like between 3 and 6 months since the first movie ended. So they've gone on a couple of missions, and they're just kind of getting comfortable with the dynamics of the crew, but they haven't worked out the kinks quite yet. All I can say is John Harrison is a very, very intelligent, brilliant guy. He knows how Starfleet works because he comes from inside Starfleet. But I'm not really at liberty to divulge anymore, or else JJ will appear out of thin air and strangle me. I think that obviously we did feel that there was an expectation that we would double down on this movie, that it would feel like it had a larger scope. But at the same time, you don't want to get too far away from Earth. That's the planet that we're all from and that we relate to, and it's actually a huge part of the Star Trek universe. So, we start on Earth, we end on Earth, but the journey that we go on is pretty pretty stellar. And I also think just the way that JJ shot this movie in the IMAX and the 3D, it's easy enough to pimp 3D. And to be honest with you, we were all kind of cynical about it. It just felt like, oh God, enough with the 3D. But then we did some test footage from the first movie, and we talked to our stereographer, which is the guy who does the 3D, and just the immaculate attention that they've paid to it. I really do feel like the experience of this movie is going to be completely and totally immersive. And it just, I love the first movie, but it feels much, much bigger, much broader, much more action-packed than the first one.